Sand Serpent, it's back!
Quick! Get off the ground or it'll pull you under!
We've got to help them! Look out! Whoa!
Come on! Get off the ground! Quick! Up, up, up!
Not again! Here!
It's a coming for me!
It's leaving. Everyone okay?
No! Another one of my melons was taken by that no-good stinking sand snake.
Sand Serpent!
You said it only comes when it rains on them there hills. Well, it sure ain't raining now.
Well, it's never done that before.
Guess it does now.
We're used to it coming every once in a while, but twice in one day is too much.
I'm not made of melons.
Don't worry, folks. We'll take care of this. We know what we're doing. So, what are we doing?
Good question. We need to get a look at this sand serpent, but it never seems to come above ground.
Not a problem. ClueBot, go! This ClueBot can track the sand serpent through its tunnels so we can see what we're dealing with. That's it!
It looks like it has fur and claws. Doesn't look like a snake to me.
It's on the move again. But we can't get close. It's kicking up too much sand. Oh, the ClueBot crashed into something.
This wall must go down pretty deep, but the serpent avoided it just in time.
If we could somehow corner the creature at this wall, we could catch it.
But how do we make it go where we want it to?
Huh? You saw that, right?
Uh-huh. And I heard it, too.
The sand serpent lives underground, but it zips away whenever there's a big noise above ground.
It's gotta have really good hearing to find its way around in those dark tunnels. Must not like loud noises.
And that's how we catch it. The next time the serpent comes back, we'll be ready for it.
Folks, we figured out that the sand serpent isn't a snake at all, and it doesn't like loud noises.
So, what is it?
Time to find out. Everyone bring their pots and pans?
Yeah, you bet.
Great. Now, Kit and I will position you around town. Then, when we tell you, make as much noise as possible. The noise will drive the creature smack into the underground wall. And that's when we'll catch it.
Now, who's ready to stop that sand serpent?
This is where you say, we are!
Come on, folks. There's nothing to be afraid of.
Easy for you to say. You didn't grow up hearing bedtime stories about the terrifying sand serpent. I'm mighty scared of that thing.
We are.
You know, someone once told me that fear is like a cage. A cage with only one way out.
The door?
Bending the bars?
It's just a saying.
The only way out is to face your fear.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I get it.
Whether you're scared of a legendary creature under the sand or a vacuum cleaner, sooner or later, we all have to face our fears so we can see that they're not so scary. Now, who's with me?
We are!
Sand serpent, it's a coming!
Positions, everyone. Go, go, go! Mr. Roots, make some noise. It's working!
Mango pots!
Keep steering it toward the wall!
Now!
Hey! I can't!
Face your fear! You can do this!
Whiskers, it worked!
Now, let's see what this sand serpent really is.
How's it going, everybody?
That's the sand serpent.
Sand serpent? Where? Where? Wait, hold on. What's a sand serpent?
Of course, Sam. It's a pink fairy armadillo.
A pink fairy? Oh, now who's telling tall tales?
Hey, I'll have you know I'm a pink fairy armadillo.